So today we're going to go through about a 60 or 70 minute yin yoga practice. This practice will have us holding poses for upwards of 3 minutes. So instead of the flow that we're used to connecting poses with our breath and moving in an almost meditative state, this will have us sitting for quite a while in singular positions, stretching out specific muscle groups and giving us time to relax and think. I'd recommend that you surround yourself with maybe your favorite scents or some candles. The music or the playlist for today will be all very slow, light sounds. And if you feel comfortable with it, you might even consider darkening the area around you, creating a specific kind of mood of relaxation and grounding for yourself. This is a practice you can turn to that will help reset your mind, but also some of these stretches, if you remember how they go, or you can always play this video back again, will really help bring the body temperature down as well as set yourself up for a nap or bedtime. I also recommend that you have your blocks and your blanket with you. This can be because as we're holding positions for a long time, maybe on our knees, it's helpful to have the padding underneath your knees, or the blocks because it can really help you absolutely relax into a position. Again, this practice isn't to help us hold or push ourselves in a way that is meant to expand us physically, but help us kind of dig into specific muscles. And in order for us to do that, we have to let the muscles around that go and release. So we'll get started in a comfortable seat, whatever's good for you, on your bum or on your legs. And we'll let our eyes come to a gentle close. Begin to focus on the sound your own breathing makes. On your next inhale, gently place your left palm on your lower belly. Feel the belly lightly expand and contract. And on the next inhale, expand more deeply and feel the hand move up and out. On the exhale, slowly let the air out of the mouth, feeling the belly move back toward the spine. Repeat this a few times, starting to use the belly muscles to push the hand out so more air can get in. Feel the whole belly expand on the sides and moving upward toward the sternum. And contract. After your next exhale, gently replace your hand, maybe back to the ground, the top of your left thigh. continue breathing like this, feeling the inhalation, breathe in all the air you can, and the exhalation, empty the belly completely out. Come back to this breath throughout our practice as you identify the places your body feels a little uncomfortable in these poses we might embody. And as you inhale the belly nice and big, send the breath to those little areas. Use the breath to expand and make room for a deeper stretch or maybe just a little more relaxation. We'll move into our first stretch from your seat. On your inhale, raise your arms up overhead and bring the fingers to touch. On your exhale, bend at the waist over to your side. Doesn't matter which side. But feel the stretch open up the side of the body. On your inhales, reach the fingers a little taller. And on your exhales, see if you can make a little more room to bend. On your next inhale, straighten up. Reach the fingers tall and bring the arms back down to your side. Give them a little break. Shake out the shoulders. Inhale, reach the fingers back up. And exhale, bend over to the other side. Again, on the inhales, reach the fingers a little taller. And on the exhales, can you make a little more room to bend over to that other side? Inhale, raise the fingers up. Exhale, place them down. In our next pose, we'll set up reaching for our block. We're going to come and lay down on our left side. Grab your block, straighten the legs out long underneath you. You may consider taking your blanket, setting it up underneath your left hip, just in case it may feel uncomfortable. We're going to take this block and we're going to set it up at the point just underneath our armpit. So the block is going to come down on the short side. We're going to be able to reach that arm nice and long. So your armpit isn't exactly on the block. It's more or less that joint where the arm and the ribs meet. We're going to reach the other hand long. So almost like when we were set and we were reaching our fingers to the sky, let the head come to lay on the left bicep. We should feel the stretch maybe in the right side body as we reach that arm long. And ideally in the left side body where the block meets the body. Again, as you inhale, reach the fingers and toes nice and long. And as you exhale, empty the belly completely. On your next exhale, place the right hand on the ground in front of the block and use the palms to push the body up. We'll roll over onto the other side. I'll demonstrate by setting my block up at the other end of the mat. Place now the right hip onto the ground and that block underneath the right armpit. Reach the hands out nice and long. Let the head come to rest on the right bicep this time. Inhale to reach the fingers and toes. Exhale to relax into the pose. On the next exhale, place the left palm onto the ground, roll up onto the bum. This time you might want to reach for your other block. We'll come down onto the belly. Bring the arms underneath the shoulders. You can keep the blanket underneath your hips if you like, or you can remove it. We'll reach the toes out nice and long. Put the palms onto the ground and use the upper back to keep the back curved, almost reaching for straight. We're in Sphinx pose. The gaze is forward. However, if you want to bring your eyes to a close, that's okay. Here we're feeling the grounding underneath our forearms, but we're not slinking our weight into our forearms. We're using the back and the abs to keep the shoulders reaching upward, to keep the chest shining forward. We'll start to feel this in the back a little. If this is uncomfortable for you in any way, feel free to walk the arms out just a little bit until the back feels comfortable. As you inhale, reach the crown of the head a little taller. As you exhale, feel forearms and the hips and the thighs melt into the mat. You may feel yourself start to shake or feel uncomfortable in some ways as we hold these poses longer than what we're used to. That's kind of the point. Although remember that yoga is never meant to hurt. So if the feeling is uncomfortable enough that it's actually causing pain, you're always welcome to take a child's pose or just simply lay in the most comfortable way. It's close to the pose. As an example, just on your belly now. But the goal of a yin class is to help us find the edge at which we can withstand some of that uncomfortability, especially if someone isn't calling out the poses for you and keeping your body and mind engaged the entire time. As you exhale, begin to reach the arms out longer in front of you. Stretch the fingers long, bring the forehead to the mat. To set up for our next pose, you'll need either one or two blocks. If one block is comfortable for you, I'll show you what that iteration looks like. With our fingers stretched long in front of us, we'll bring our hands to kind of a steeple or prayer pose, and we'll bend them back behind to the nape of our neck. The elbows can stay on the ground. You'll bring the forehead to a block. If this is comfortable and feels good, stay here. Or you may consider introducing a second block, bringing your elbows to them rather, keeping the forehead on the ground. This will feel a little deeper of a stretch in the backs of the arms, which might feel comfortable for you today. With each inhale, fill the belly and send breath to the part of the body that needs it most. With your exhale, release your shoulders away from your ears. Send the shoulder blades down the back and wiggle the tongue so it feels a little less tight. On the next exhale, bring the arms back out in front of you and remove the blocks, place them off to the side. Push yourself up into a tabletop position, hands and knees on the mat. Bring the fingers to point toward your knees, essentially reversing the hand position that you would normally take. And begin to sit back down on the heels. Feel the stretch in the back of the wrists, which just happen to be pointing forward. Especially after a day of sitting at a computer, if that's what your current role causes or calls for you, this can feel especially delightful. On the inhale, bring the hips back up off the heels. Let's actually turn the wrists, fingers pointing back at our knees, this time on the tops of our hands. So our palms are facing upward. And as you exhale, begin to sit back onto the heels again, feeling the stretch in the opposite direction. Again, as you exhale, let the shoulders fall away from the ears. Stretch the neck out nice and long. On the next inhale, raise the hips up off of the heels. And this time, take the hands off the mat, bring the torso up over the knees. Raise the hands up overhead and just roll out the wrists. Should feel pretty good and also maybe a little sore. It's not often we spend that much time putting weight and pressure in that place. Bring the hands down to the ground and start to set yourself up for puppy pose. Imagine a playful new puppy. Their hips stay over their knees, but they bring their chest down to the ground. So as you roll yourself out, you'll reach your hands out long in front of you. Bring the chest and chin down, keeping the hips over the knees as best you can. The butt is right up in the air. If this happens to feel a little uncomfortable for you in your back, it's okay to maybe bring your forehead to a block. This can keep the chest a little elevated and release a little pressure on the back. Whatever feels comfortable for you, it is slightly awkward. It's kind of supposed to be. But what we're doing here is feeling an opening in the tops of our shoulders,
or feeling some of the work we did in our back a little earlier. On your inhale, focus on sending breath to the middle of the back, to the tops of the shoulders. On the inhale, press into the forearms. Rotate the body so that it comes up over those forearms. And then bring yourself up onto your palms. Walk your hands back into your tabletop position. Spread the knees out really wide, all the way to the outer edges of the mat here. Bring the toes to touch behind us. And on an exhale, we'll sit the bum back to the heels, reach the fingers out long, and bring the forehead all the way to the ground. Notice the huge difference when we're not keeping our hips over our knees. This child's pose is a respite from the puppy pose we just held. On the inhales, focus on expanding the belly as much as you can, feeling the ribs widen and the back slightly puff up. On the exhale, empty all the way out. Maybe reach the fingers a little bit longer in front of you. Next inhale, raise the hips back up to your tabletop position. And bring those hands underneath your shoulders. Have a block ready just in front of you on the lowest setting, meaning the long, placing it on the long edge, long flat. On an inhale, we'll reach the right fingers up to the sky. On the exhale, we're going to thread the right hand underneath the left armpit. We're gonna bring the right shoulder down to the ground. And here's where a block comes into play. We'll take the right temple to the block. Try, if you can, to get the right palm on the ground. Reach the left fingers, straightening the left arm toward the top of the mat. Feel the stretch in the outer right shoulder. On the next inhale, slowly start to walk the left fingers back toward your block and push into the right hand to lift up the head, the shoulder, and eventually sending that right hand back to the sky. Exhale to place it down. Inhale, we'll start on the other side. Send the left fingers to the sky. Exhale, thread the left hand underneath the right armpit. Reach the fingers nice and long. Bring the left shoulder to the ground, and eventually the left temple back to your block. As you inhale, walk the right fingers to the top of the mat. Feel the shoulder stretch on the left. Again, remembering on the inhale to expand the belly all the way. Feel it stretch. And as you exhale, emptying out completely. on your inhale, begin to walk those right fingers back beside your block. Push into the right hand to unwind the body. Send those left fingers back up to the sky. Exhale to bring them down. And take the block back away from your mat area, setting it off to the side. Back down onto the belly, lowering all the way down. And spreading the arms nice and wide like an airplane, reaching them off to each side of your mat. On an inhale, I'll start with the left side. We're going to roll over to the left side of the body. So push, using the right hand to push us up onto the left hip. And maybe even if you're feeling good for it today, bend the right knee and place it on the ground behind. So we're using the extended left arm to open up the front of the left chest. Might even get a nice crack in the lower back, depending on how your body's feeling today. Right hand stays in front of the face, palm on the ground. Continue expanding the belly on your inhales. Feeling the air stretch the skin and muscles just a little bit more than if you were breathing normally. Exhale to use the right foot to push the body back onto the belly, placing both hips back down and eventually replacing the hands underneath the shoulders. Bring those arms back in tight against the body. Stretch the neck nice and long. The crown of the head is reaching toward the front of the mat, the top. As we exhale, reach the right arm out now, using the left palm to push yourself up onto the right side body. That left knee bends, placing the sole of the left foot on the ground behind the right leg. Take one last large inhale here. And on the exhale, use the foot to push the body back onto the belly. Bring the forehead to the mat. And again, bring both arms in close to the body. Stretch the neck nice and long. Inhale, lift the head and use the hands to push you into your tabletop position. We're now going to set up for half pigeon pose. So we'll bring the right knee up to the right wrist and we'll swivel the right ankle close to the left wrist. In this position, we want the shin of the right leg to be as parallel to the top of the mat as possible. We'll untuck the left toes and take a quick glance back to make sure the leg is nice and long behind us, straight behind the left hip, not jutting out to either side. I would grab one of your blocks again, and this time set it up on one of the higher settings. So one of the short ends, or either the short end, so it's reaching as tall as possible, or the long skinny end, so that it's in what we call middle position. On the inhale, tent the fingers. So you're standing up on the pads of the fingers and reach the spine nice and long. The crown of the head reaches to the sky, shoulders fall away from the ears. On the exhale, fold over and bring the forehead to the block. If you got a little adventurous and advantageous and you brought it to that middle setting, but really you need it at the taller setting, that's okay. The idea here is to ensure the head is resting on the block, so we're not exerting our effort with our arms or our neck or our back. We're leaving our bodies to feel the whole stretch in the outer right thigh, the glute and the hip. On the exhale, try to relax into the pose. If it's just not feeling good for you today and you need a little more support, you can take your other block and actually place it up underneath that right hip. If it's too much stretch, if it's not the right feeling, that's okay. Totally acceptable. Take that block, give yourself that support that you might need by sliding it underneath and replacing the forehead. Feel a little bit of the stretch, but remember, it's not supposed to hurt. Pay attention to the jaw. Make sure it's nice and loose, not clenched. On the inhale, send breath all the way down to the hips. And as you exhale, let go of the building tension, the building discomfort, to find a little ease in this big stretch. On the inhale, lift the head and begin to walk the hands back toward the right knee. Push with the hands to loosen the leg from the mat and send the knee back toward the left, slowly entering into your tabletop. Wiggle or wave the hips from left to right. Put a little movement in to loosen up what you just did. On the exhale, walk the hands forward again, bringing the left leg forward. Setting yourself up, stretch out that right knee long behind you, reaching the toes for the back end of the mat, and glancing back quickly to make sure that it's straight. The left ankle is near the right wrist. Tent the fingers, and on the inhale, reach the crown of the head tall. The spine comes straight, making space in the hips for the exhale and fold. Walk the fingers forward and rest your forehead on your block. Again, if it's just not comfortable and you're feeling too much strain in that left hip, feel free to take your other block and place it underneath to find yourself a little ease. On the inhale, slowly raise your forehead from your block and begin to walk your fingers back toward your left leg. Maybe you tuck the toes of the right foot just to make enough room to drag that left leg back. Bring both knees to the ground. Remove your block from your mat. Wave those hips from left to right, making a little room in the body after such a big stretch. This next stretch we'll take on our back. So walk your knees forward and bring yourself down to your butt. Stretch the legs out long in front of you and take the body all the way down to your back. We'll bend our knees and hug them into our chest. Big, big, big hug. And on the exhale, take the knees off toward the right side of the mat, keeping the left shoulder down. Feel the spinal twist. Take the arms in a cactus-like shape, bending 90 degrees at the elbow. If the knees don't come all the way down to the ground comfortably, you might consider resting them on your block or even your folded blanket. The goal here is to have both your knees and your left shoulder blade on the ground comfortably, or supported comfortably is probably the right way to say it. On the next inhale, raise both knees back to neutral. Hug them back into your chest. On the exhale, let them slowly fall to the other side of your mat. Again, maybe bringing the block or your blanket to the left side. Thank you. Next inhale, raise both knees back into the chest, straightening the spine. Exhale, place the soles of the feet on the ground. And if you don't have it handy, head and rise up to grab a block. Lie back down and lift the hips to place the block under your sacrum. If you're not familiar, it feels like the place where your spine meets your tailbone, the flat part of your back, right before your bum starts. We're going to raise our knees up, taking the soles of our feet off the ground. And on an exhale, fully extend the legs all the way up to the sky. The back is supported, shoulder blades on the ground, shoulders melted away from the ears, palms up, the small of our back, the sacrum supported by our block, the soles of our feet pointed toward the sky. Also known as supported legs up the wall. Exhale, go ahead and bend the knees, slowly lower the soles of the feet, one at a time, to the ground. Push into the heels to lift the hips and remove the block. Take both blocks out by your sides. Bring the heels of the feet to touch, like you're setting up for your high school gym butterfly stretch, but laying down on the ground. Place the blocks at whatever height feels best for you underneath the knees. So they come to rest with the heels of the feet still touching, and the rest of the soles of the feet still touching. Stay on your back. This will be the position we take our Savasana in today. There's no shame in using these blocks on the highest setting, if that's what feels good today. if the insides of the legs are feeling particularly stretchy, it may feel good to put it on the smallest setting. Inhale, and as you exhale, roll the shoulders open. Tuck them underneath the chest for a broad front of body as you splay the arms out, palms up. Ensure that you're on the very back part of your head so that you have the straightest neck possible. Exhale to completely release, letting go of any tension left in the body. Feel relaxation come over. You can feel free to stay in your savasana if you choose. It's quite a relaxing, happy place. But if you'd like to close class with me, slowly release the blocks from underneath your knees. Straighten the legs out long in front of you. Take a big breath here. Reach the fingers up to the sky. On your next exhale, roll over to the right side almost putting yourself into a fetal position. And use your left hand to push yourself up into a seat. Thank you for practicing with me today. Again, this is a yin yoga practice designed to increase our flexibility and give us that little extra push in places we may not feel so flexible in. It's a great way to build muscle and increase that flexibility. Remember to drink a lot of water after this class. Rehydrate your muscles after squeezing all the water out of them. Thanks so much.